insects, they're pockets of protection.
One of the big things that we're getting a lot of questions about right now are fall webworms. There's worms actually in there. They're actually technically caterpillars. They're little hairy caterpillars, and they form this silken cocoon, and then they actually congregate on the inside of that, and then they feed on the leaves that are inside of that web.
Hannah Smith at the North Carolina Cooperative Extension says they can feed on leaves from summer throughout the fall, and that can continue during winter.
Then they'll actually fall to the ground with the leaves, and then they'll form a cocoon on the ground, either in the debris or in the soil, and then they'll emerge in the summer and start the whole life cycle all over again.
Webworms won't destroy the tree, but if you don't want to see the web, there are some options for removing them.
A lot of times we get calls about these. It's unsightly. A lot of people want to know what they can do to get rid of it. And one of the things that we tell folks is if it's in a reachable distance, you can actually just kind of take and open it up with the web.
Wow.
And you can, if it's not sticky, a spider web.
It almost feels like a cotton ball.
It does, yeah. So you can just take and open it up, and one of the great things is the birds love to eat these caterpillars. So it's a great food source for the birds. So you're providing, you know, the food source for a little higher up in the food chain. Wasps also will attack the caterpillars there as well.
Smith says one thing you should absolutely not do is burn webworms.
That's not safe. Please do not do that. And insecticides aren't necessary either, because these insects are not going to kill the tree.
Natalie Wilson, Fox 8 News.
And August is when we